Hi friends, in the previous video I was already explained how to move n number of bytes from internal RAM to external memory, right? So in this video let us see reverse. For example, we should move n number of bytes from external memory location to internal RAM. Let us see how to write the program. Okay, see the problem. Write an assembly language program. See, write an assembly language program to transfer or to move n bytes from external memory to internal RAM of 8051 microcontroller. Okay, so we should move n bytes from external memory to internal RAM. Okay, let us see how to write the program. Here also, what is first step? First, how many bytes we should move? That is essential. For that, move R0 comma #05. Here also, my aim is I need to move n bytes from external memory to internal RAM. For that, move R0 comma #05. Then automatically my R0 receiving 05 data. That is my count. Then what is the next step? For selecting the external memory, I need a 16-bit register. For that, I am writing move DPTR comma as, for example, just for a change, 5000H. So my external memory and start from 5000. How many locations I need to take? Because my count is 5, so 5 locations. 5000, 5001, 2, 3, 4, like that. Next, similarly, for internal RAM, I need one more register for selecting internal RAM. That's why move R1 comma hash. For example, internal RAM, I'm considering 50H. So then move R1 comma hash 50H means my R1 is equal to 50H. Okay. Then which register can take data from external memory? R1 may not take, only through accumulator is possible. For that, move X, accessing data from external memory, move X is essential. A comma at the rate DPTR. In this instruction, what happens? My A takes data from 5000 memory location. Okay, then that particular data is now transferred to which one? Internal RAM of 50H. For that, move at the rate R1 comma A. In that instruction, what happens? A takes data from 5000 memory location, and that particular data is transferred to 50H memory location. At the rate R1 means now the address receiving data. Which address? R1 address. What is R1 address? 50. So 50 address now receiving data from A. But A receiving data from which one? 5000. Like that, one byte is moved from external RAM to internal RAM. Like that, I need to make it same operation for five bytes. For that, increment DPTR. Increment DPL is enough because 5 only. 5000 becomes 5001 automatically. Lower byte only. Incrementing higher byte won't affect. That's why 5000 becomes 5001. Simply if write increment DPL. Similarly, increment R1. R1 is also incrementing, means RAM becomes 50 becomes now 51. Here 5000 becomes 5001. Then whether we are checking whether count reached to 00 or not. For that, decrement jump no 0. Which register? R0. We are checking R0 whether it's a 00 or not, and we are decrementing R0 and checking whether it's 00 or not. For that, decrement jump no 0 R0 comma L1. It's a one loop L1. Where it will go? Here. So initially what happens? First, initially A receiving data from 5000 and the data is moved to 50. The later DPTR is incremented 5000 into 5001. R1 is 50 becomes 51. Decrement jump no 0 means it will check whether R0 is decrementing. After decrementing, what is R0? 05 becomes 04. Is it 0? 0? No. 04 is not 00. Then this condition is true, it will go here. Then A takes data from which one? 5001, because already DPL is incrementing. So A takes data from 5001. That particular data is transferred to address of R1. What is address of R1? 51. Okay, then again our DPL is incrementing. 5001 becomes 5002. R1 becomes 51 becomes 52. Again R0 is decrementing. 04 becomes 03. Is it 00? No, again it will go. Like that, this loop repeats for how many times? 5 times. Okay. Like that, we are taking data from external memory and sending the data to internal memory with the help of accumulator register. Then simply end of the program. This is the program for moving 5 bytes from external memory to internal RAM. Later, we need to copy same program into Keel software. For that, open Keel. Already one program is there. Just make it stop the debugging of previous. Select project. Then new project. Assume it's a fifth program, I think. So that's why I'm selecting program 5 as my project name, PROG5. Okay, so it will ask which device we need to take. So always we should take AT89C51 device. It comes under micro G family. Select this one, then okay. Okay, startup is also not required. Now we are selecting program file. Then select file, then select new. In that you copy your entire program here. Okay, enlarge if you want. You can enlarge here like this. It will ask what is the file name. So program 5 PROG5.asm. Extension should be assembly language program .asm. Then save. Okay. Then later select a target. Select a plus of target. Then in that source group present in that source group select right click. Then select add existing files to this group. Okay. In that you give your program path program5.asm. After adding, we get plus symbol here, then close. Okay, so now like that, we are adding program file also to project. The later build target or press F5 directly. So target is building. So see here, there is no errors and no warnings. So program is okay. Later, select debug, then start debugging. It will ask whether the size is more than 2K or not. So limit is okay, within 2K only. Okay. So here also, now first we should select memory. So which memory we need to take? We need to take first external memory. In that we should give our 5 bytes, and later those 5 bytes will move to internal RAM. So what is the address I am taking for external memory? X capital X colon 0x5000, because I need to select 5000 for the 5000 location. So initially 5000 location contains all reset values, nothing but all zeros. For example, here I am considering my numbers are, for example, A. For example, B, C, D, just double click and give your name, your required value. Okay, A, B, C, D, E, for example. Okay, 5 bytes only. A, B, C, D, E, enough. Okay, 5 bytes only. Right. So 5 bytes A, B, C, D, E, like that. I'm giving 5 bytes starts from 5000. Okay, then parallelly we need to see 50 location also. For that only one memory window is available. In order to take another memory window, you select view, then select memory window. Already memory one is highlighted, that's why we are selecting. Then select memory two. Four memories at a time we can see. So memory two, in that memory which one we need to select for internal RAM, it should be D:50H, because in our program we are starting internal RAM with 50, so that's why 50. Initially all are of zero value. Okay, like that both windows are available now. Then later you enter into step mode. So select first step F11, step F11, or press this one. Initially we are in this line. Okay, in order to execute this line, you select this one. Now that instruction is executing. After executing, what is R0 value? Becomes 05. R0 becomes 05. Then next instruction. Okay, this instruction now executing. If you want, you can enlarge this one. So DPTR initially 4 zeros. Now if you execute this instruction, DPTR becomes 5000. Verify. After executing, DPTR becomes now 5000. Now it is ready to execute this instruction. After executing this instruction, R1 becomes 50. Initially, what is R1 value? 00. If executed, let us see. After executing, R1 becomes 50. Then now we are in this line. If you execute this instruction automatically, what happens? A takes data from 5000. So which data is available in 5000? A. 0A is available. That 0A is now loaded into A register. Let us see. After executing this instruction, now 0A is enter into A register, A receiving data from 5000 memory location. Then the data will move to 50. For that, we should execute this instruction. After executing this instruction, if you update 50 location, 0A is available. See here, 50 location now receiving 0A. So from accumulator, the data is transferred to internal RAM of 50H location. Okay, then DPL is incrementing next instruction. If you let us execute, DPL is incrementing, the 5000 becomes now what is the value? DPTR becomes 5000. R1 also initially 50. Let us increment what happens. 50 becomes now R151. Then decrement jump no zero. If you execute this instruction, what happens? R0 is decrementing from 05 to 04. Initially R0 is 05. Let us see if I am executing this one. What is R0 now? 05 becomes 04. Is it 00? No. Again, what happens? My loop will jump to this line. Okay. If you execute this line, what happens? A takes data from 5001. Nothing but 0B will enter into A register. Let us see. See here. 0B is enter into A register, because next location 0B is enter into A register. Okay, if we execute next instruction, this 0B will enter into this one. Okay, 51 location automatically. Let us see. Now 51 location contains 0B. Like that, it will done automatically. RAM, external memory sending data to accumulator sending data to internal RAM automatically. Like that, this loop repeats for how many times? 5 times. Okay, remaining the steps I will okay directly will just execute like that. If you see, here now third byte is transferred from external to internal. 0C is loaded. Similarly, fourth iteration. See, fourth byte also loaded from external memory to internal memory. Last one also. Let us see same way. Like that, five bytes from 5000 to 5004 bytes are successfully transferred to 50H to 54H of internal RAM memory. Okay, so like that, external data is transferred from external memory to internal RAM easily. Okay, so I hope you understand how to move n number of bytes from external memory to internal RAM memory location. If you really like, please kindly share my video to your friends and subscribe my channel. Okay, thank you so much.